Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for coming tonight. At approximately 18:05, that's about 5 minutes after 6 o'clock at night, the yo-yo ride, that's Y-O-Y-O ride, it's a circular chain-suspended carriage ride, collapsed. With a downward motion, with the victims inside of the carriage, fell to the base and the ground of the yo-yo ride. We had a total of 23 victims, three of which were immediately airlifted to local regional hospitals. 20 victims were transported by a combination of either private parties, ambulances, or were uninjured and walked away. No fatalities were reported at the time. The cause of the incident is currently being investigated by both the Calaveras County Sheriff's Office and the California Safety and Health Occupational Administration. And we'll know more, a little more about that later on. All of the rides in the fairgrounds have been closed down. However, all the existing programming and all the other activities in the fair continue as they're originally scheduled. Let me introduce Ray Mallerby.
Can I just ask you one, what's your name, please, first?
Clay Hawkins, H-A-W-K-I-N-S, Captain, Calaveras County Sheriff's Office.
And Clay, just to reiterate, there's no fatalities.
No fatalities as we are talking right now.
Okay, good. Do you know the conditions of the people taking the hospital?
We don't have conditions on the victims in the hospital. Okay. Other than no fatalities. Okay.
Did all of them go to the same hospital?
Regional hospitals. The three that were airlifted, the 20 remaining went to, again, regional hospitals and by ground in private transportation.
Are you going to list a, or just give a list of those hospitals and the people who were injured?
We can provide that for you later, sure.
Of the, you said there were three airlifted and there were 20 others.
Correct.
How many of the 20 are hurt?
All 20, a combination of the 20 were moved by ground ambulance and private vehicles to local regional hospitals, and several walked away and were not transported. We don't have a good count yet of how many actually left the scene and were okay.
And for anyone that is concerned about their children here at the fair and wondering whether they were involved in the accident, we will be open tonight. Our phone lines will be open tonight. And people can call. It's area code 209-736-2561. We will also have that phone line open all day tomorrow and Sunday from 8 a.m. to 11 p.m. for tomorrow. That's speculation at this point. It's possible, but speculation.
Do you know how old the yo-yo is?
I do not. We will have that information. We'll be gathering further information and have more tomorrow.
Do you know anything about the operator of the yo-yo time?
The individual ride operator. There were actually three ride operators, all of which have agreed to be tested, and they've all been transported for a blood test.
You anticipate the investigation going through the night, or will you shut the place down and come back tomorrow?
No, we'll continue. The investigation will continue, correct.
And again, let us reiterate that the fair, all the other activities at the fair will be going on, and we will open again tomorrow at 10 o'clock. There will be frog jumping and entertainment in our buildings.
What would you guess the range in the ages are for the people that are on the ride?
That's difficult. It seems that the oldest person was 21 years old. The others were younger.
Do you have the status on the three that were airlifted?
We do not at this point.
Do you have their ages?
I do not have that.
Correct. Yes. Any other questions?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.